How do you build a bottom sheet in SwiftUI that is a specific size? And also, how do you give the user the option to adjust that size? That's what I'm going to show you today. I'm jumping right into showing the bottom sheet with the custom sizes, but for those of you that are curious about the map, the button styles, stick around to the end, I'll explain all that. The first step to showing a bottom sheet with a custom size is showing a sheet. So let's do that, and then we'll talk about the modifiers you add to customize it. We're gonna add our sheet to this button here, and this button is the pink button in the lower left over there on the preview. So to do that, we'll do dot sheet, and you see is presented in content, so that's what we'll do. So we need to flip a Boolean to show this. We don't have that Boolean yet, so on line 12 up here, let's do at state private var is showing travel modes, and that equals false by default. So now our sheet needs a binding to that Boolean, so dollar sign is showing travel mode. We need to show a view in this sheet, and that's this travel option view. Real quick, it's just a V stack with this text and then an H stack of buttons that you saw in that preview that will show up in this sheet. You'll see it here in a second. Again, at the end of the video, I'm gonna run through the whole project for those that are curious. So what I wanna show is travel option view. So now that I know what view I'm showing, I need to toggle this Boolean when the button is tapped. So we'll do is showing travel modes dot toggle when this pink button in the lower left is tapped. New in Xcode 14, the preview is always running live, so let's hit this button, and there's our sheet. Now, it is a full sheet, right? We want the customizable bottom sheet. But like I said, the first step into customizing the size is showing the sheet. Now that we have our sheet to work with, let's customize the size, and that is a simple modifier on the travel option view. And that modifier is presentation detents. And you can see it takes in an array of detents. So there are some built-in ones, so we'll do dot medium, and dot large. You see, those are the only two options as of right now, but you see custom, fraction, height. That's how you can pass in very specific stuff, but let's do medium and large first to show you that in action. So because I'm passing in medium and large, this gives the user the option to drag up to make it bigger, right? I'm gonna tap my button, there you go, that's medium, and then I can drag up to large, swipe back down to medium, right? So we're medium to large. Those are the built-in ones. And by the way, see this little handle? That shows up automatically when you have two of them. If you only have one, we'll refresh the preview, medium, right? So now you see I can't scroll up to make it bigger because I only passed in medium. And you see there's no handle because there's no option. What you can do though, presentation drag indicator, and you see you can pass in a visibility. So visibility, hidden, automatic, visible. Let's always make it visible in case you want that. I like the look of that personally. So you tap this, even though there's only one option, I got the handle. I don't know, I always like seeing the handle. So I'm always gonna make it visible. But just so you know, if you only pass in one option, it'll be invisible by default. So we'll swipe that down. That is the built-in medium.large, right? But let's say that doesn't really work for you, right? Because if you look, that's pretty big. We just have these four buttons. I kind of want it like small for my UI. So let's comment out the medium and large. I'm gonna leave it there just so you can see it. And I'll add it again, presentation detents, pass in the set here, dot custom fraction. Let's do fraction. So what I like about fraction is you can just say 10%, 20%, 30%, 50%. So for mine, let's say I want 0.20. So now when I tap the car, that looks a lot better for my specific UI, right? It's just an H stack of buttons. I don't need the thing to go huge, right? See, I can't make it big. It's just that little thing. And when I pick a button, well, we haven't done that yet. Let's actually do that real quick just to show you. So in my travel options view, like I said, it's this H stack of buttons that you see with a button style, travel mode button. I haven't talked about this button style yet, but it's basically just the UI for this button. I'll explain that at the end. So button airplane, I have a variable up here for selected travel name. It's car.fill. So when airplane is tapped, you can do selected travel name equals airplane. You can probably make this an enum so you don't have to retype that, but let's do this real quick to show you this app in action. Selected travel name car.fill, selected travel name ferry.fill, and selected travel name is tram.fill. And then also when they tap an option, we want to do is showing travel modes dot toggle, right? We want to dismiss the view here. So copy, paste that into each button. So now when I tap the button, we get my little 20% card that I can't swipe off and make bigger. I'm gonna tap the boat, and then now you see my button is the boat, because that's what I did up here for the button. The button style here is the selected travel name, which we're changing on button tap. Okay, cool. So that's 20%, but now, again, this is a set. So you can see I can pass in dot fraction, say 0.4. I can pass in a bunch of these. So we'll do dot fraction 0.6, dot fraction 0.8. Okay, now obviously this is not great for my UI, but maybe you need some of this, so watch. So I tap that, there's 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%, right? And you can make these fractions whatever you like for your app. Obviously that doesn't really make sense for ours, but just wanna let you know that you can do that. So that is fractions. Also what you can do is if you need something very specific, I recommend doing the fractions just so it handles like the various phone sizes. Like, hey, Ali, I want this 10% of the phone, 20% of the phone. But you can do custom where you do dot height and you can pass in like, I don't know, 300. Oh, I need to get rid of dot custom, right? Because I have dot height there, right? So presentation indents, and then you pass in a set of very specific heights. And now when I tap that, that will be 300. So as you can see, like here, you can use the built-in system ones. Well, you can't have two of them, I don't believe. You can do custom fractions, 20%, 40%, 80%, or you can pass in a specific height, and then you can make the drag indicator visible or not visible. So now we're back to the medium and large that comes by default, and the user can change that. Okay, that's the custom bottom card. If you're curious about the map and the button styles, I'll run through that real quick. So in SwiftUI, a map is just a map object that takes in a region. You see I'm doing dot ignore safe area, so it fills up the whole phone, as you see on my preview. So what this region is, see MK coordinate region, it's two things. It looks like a lot of code. It's just latitude and longitude. You need to know where to show on the map, right? And then span is how zoomed in you are. So 0.1 is about this zoomed in. Just to give you an example, if I do 0.9, and 0.9, you can see how zoomed out I get on my preview. Again, looks like a lot of code. It's just a lat and long, and how zoomed in are you? So you pass that region into the map, and that's a Z stack, right, with the map on the bottom, and the alignment on the Z stack is bottom leading. That way my button is in the lower left. I gave it a button style of a travel mode button where I pass in the name. So down here in the custom button styles, you see you have a travel mode button, of type button style, where I have a property of a string. That's where I'm passing that in here, system image name for the SF symbol. And then you do make body with a configuration. And then this is basically whatever UI you want on your button. So our button is just, you know, the image with the SF symbol, you know, foreground color white, give it a frame, padding, background color pink, clip shaped circle. So that's what made that button. And then, you know, travel option view is just a refactored view. Like I could have written all this code out in my sheet right here, but that's a little messy. And it's just an H stack of the four buttons, as you see here. And then, like we said, you present the sheet like normal. And on the view that you present, you just add some presentation detents modifiers. And, you know, you can pass in medium large for the built-in, you can pass in a custom height, you can pass in a fraction, and you can make your drag indicator visible. That's it for custom bottom sheets in SwiftUI. If you like my teaching style, I have my own iOS developer courses. Check it out at SeanAllen.teachable.com.